गुड मॉर्निंग। एज आई हैव रिफर्ड टू डिस्कस इन डिटेल विद द लीगल पॉइंट्स ऑफ द पर्टिकुलर केस इन कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ द सर्विस कंडीशंस ऑफ द वर्किंग जर्नलिस्ट एंड अदर एम्प्लॉयज ऑफ द न्यूज़पेपर। एज यू हैव सीन द डेफिनेशन क्लॉज and the interpretation of definition clause somehow we have already discussed, but remaining part with the help of the case law as decided by the Supreme Court and laid down certain principles to apply the that act, particularly of the definition sections which comes within the purview of the act as prescribed words, that this is there. Then I have just quoted one case, that is a famous case, though there are very cases in the name of that company, Binet Coleman Company Private Limited. It is a newspaper publishing company, and some working journalists were working in that company, and there was a dispute relating to their service conditions, and these conditions were perhaps in the relation of the wages and the definition, as well as some special clauses as prescribed under the Indian the Industrial Dispute Act 1947. Then in detail, if we will involved in that analysis for portion of the case, it is a case which was the respondent, that Poonia Priya Das Gupta was the respondent in this case, and he was the correspondent, and correspondent is under the category of the working journalist as prescribed. You have seen this definition under the provisions of this law, and which says that the definition, what is the definition of the working journalist under the section 2F of the 1955 Act. That is the point. And another point was related to the definition section 2EEE, which is basically defines the word wages. And at the same time, another aspect was in the issue in this case, that was the newspaper establishment and the non-journalist newspapers and the newspaper and the employee also, employee of the newspaper sector. All these definitions were form of the issue in that case. And apart these definition clause, there were the issue of section 5 and section 17 of the 1955 Act. At the same time, some other laws which were related to the Industrial Dispute Act, Industrial Dispute Act, and that involves the section 20 of that Act, 1947 Act, because as you have seen, the clause G of section 2 say that if any word is not prescribed under section 2 of 1955 Act, which is related to the working journalist and other employees, service conditions and miscellaneous provisions, these words will be taken into consideration. These words means the words prescribed under the Indian the Industrial Dispute Act 1947. These words shall be taken into the consideration if any word is not prescribed under section 2 of 1955 Act, which is related to the working journalist and the other employees of the newspaper sector, their service conditions and the miscellaneous provisions of that act. Now, one and two laws are involved. One portion is, you have seen the provisions of the definition clauses was in issue, and another was section 5, section 17, and at the same time, the section 20 of the ID Act, and which is called here and after the ID Act. It means the Industrial Dispute Act 1947. And the Section 2 in the Finance Commission Miscellaneous Provision Act 1951. And most important section was there, as you have already read, the Law of Evidence at the LLB level. And Law of Evidence is applicable in all the laws, including the criminal law, civil law, and the itself, it is a procedure law, but some portion of the Evidence Act is related to the substantive portion, and that is the subject matter of the administrative law, and some portion I have discussed in the LLM first semester also. And a very important aspect of this Law of Evidence is 115. That is called 105, which is related to the estoppel of the Law of Evidence. And this is a basically of it is a law of the substantive law. When the student are coming in this admitting portion, that is disturbing, because once the time is concentrate for teaching to the student, that is very difficult to disturb, to give the attention in another portion. Okay. Now I have said that the what were the laws involved in that matters. These laws were related to the 1955 Act, 1947 Act, and at the same time 1951 Act, and the another part was 1872 Act, which is called the Law of Evidence in this regard. These were the controversial matter in this case of the Bient Coleman Company, of the, which is decided in 1969. April 1969, but reported in the journal, that is the All India Reporter also. It is also published in the SCC, because the SCC has been started from the 1969. Before that, the SCC has not been published, and that is the year of the publishing of SCC Supreme Court cases. And mostly now the Supreme Court is referring the citation of the SCC, because it is easily available, number one. And number two, the only Supreme Court cases are being published in the SCC. That's why this is also the very easy for the court to search, and as well as for the practitioner lawyers to search the judgments from the SCC. 1969, it has been started to be published, and the EIR has been published from the 1924, if you will see. So therefore, the citation of this case is 1970, and the page number, that is the 426. It should be your habit to keep all these points in our memory. Because the memorization of the law system is deemed to be a very good system of the particular person who is entering, who has been entered into this legal domain. And that's why the some points should be kept in mind, at least at the time when it is being used. Now, the what are the cases which has been taken into consideration by the court, Supreme Court especially, for deciding this matter? Because the cases always for in support and in against and for and against this, this is the duty of the advocate to cite it, to cite these cases for own favor. Therefore, if relevant, both the cases will be cited by the court at the time of the judgment, or at the time of the delivering the judgment, and at the time or in the judgment, the court's duty is to cite the judgments which have presented, which have placed by the both the party for their own support. For their own support. Therefore, what are the cases? Mass Construction Private Limited versus Air Force Housing Board, 28th November, then 2011. National Building Construction versus the Pritam Singh Gill case of 1972, Standard Chartered Grants case, Union of India, 16th January 2007. This is the later on cases, but it is a judgment of the 2017. These are the unique judgment. These are the unique decisions which has cited by the court in the judgment for the supporting the judgment or for rejecting the argument given by the another party advocate. Now, another, after this systematic study, first, as you have said, the name of the case and in which year and what was the date of the decision, that should be memorized by the student. Then second, when it has published, that was the issue. That was not the issue. That is the point. And then another aspect is related to involve of the law. In this case, you have seen section 20 of the ID Act. You have seen the section 5 and 17 of this 1955 working condition, all these of natural newspaper workers. And then you have seen the definition clause, which is prescribed under section 2F and 2EE of the, because it is very speedily I am completing this judgment of today, if the time will permit me. And I will upload this lecture on the YouTube, and you can try to listen it again and again. That will be beneficiary for you. And a repetition of the hearing, and try to understand what is the main points. Then after that, come into the facts. What were the facts in this case? And the facts were there. One respondent, Poonia Priya Das Gupta, was working in that company, Vinet Coleman company, that is publishing the Times of India and these papers, he was working, and he was in the capacity of the correspondent. And correspondent, you have seen, comes within the definition of the working journalist under section 2F of the act, which says that who is the working journalist under that category. The correspondent is comes within the purview of that definition, because it is written whole time, part time, editor, letter editor, news editor, feature writer, copy tester, reporter, correspondent, cartoonist, newspaper, news photographer, and the proofreader. These are the working journalists. Therefore, he comes within the purview of within the definition of the section 2F as a working journalist. He was working the as Priya Phonia is working as the correspondent working journalist in the company of the Binath Coleman Private Limited. And what was happened? Facts. Issue which are very relevant facts. All the facts never be the relevant, but some facts are relevant fact. As you have seen the definition under the Evidence Act, there is one definition. If you will search section 3 and like this, that the relevant fact and the issue in the case, these are very very useful term which requires to be applied by the legal practitioner as well as the PG student who are pursuing this course of LLM to that relevant fact. What were the relevant in facts in this case? That the Poonia Priya Das Gupta was the correspondent in the Binath Coleman Private Limited company. And he had working in this capacity, but he had resigned from the company and joined the another newspaper agency, that is the Indian Express. He had joined, and but he had at the time when he has tendered the resignation was on leave, and he has not given the notice. 1 month notice is required, because according to the service rules of the newspapers or some other rules are there, that 3 months and 1 month, like that, all these things are there. But that notice can be condoned by the employer. Sometimes there is the provision. If you will see the service law, and you will get this rule, and the notice is required to be submitted from leaving the service. Or if a person wants to tender the resignation, the notice is essential to give to the employer by the employee. That he has not been given. And at the time of the resignation, he was on leave. That is the point. But what was happened? He has joined the Indian Express. Another offer he has received from the Indian Express. And Binath Coleman company has accepted his resignation, and at the same time his lump sum claim was given to him, that was the 2810 rupees, that was given lump sum to him. But one issue was there. facts are there, he was correspondent, there is no problem. And he has tendered the resignation. This is another relevant fact. Third relevant fact is that at the time of tendering the resignation, he was on leave. This is the third relevant facts. And fourth was his lump sum amount was paid by check to him, to the respondent. That is the name of the respondent is Ponia Priya Das Gupta. And lump sum amount was paid to him. Another relevant fact was that at the time of sanctioning the resignation, as he had given the resignation, that the employer has asked to the person, to the respondent, Ponia Priya Das Gupta, to give the basically of put the signature on the receipt of the payment. That was the 2,810 lump sum amount. Whole claim was set aside and it has given to him. And he has received the check, put the signature. Then by receiving the check as a condition, the employer has accepted his resignation. It has accepted. Later on, when resignation has been accepted, he has joined in another newspaper sector, that is the Indian Express. Now, what has happened after leaving the Bient Coalman company? He has claimed the leave. He has claimed the leave, and in lieu of the leave, he has submitted an application to pay the compensation. That was the issue. These are the relevant facts, as you have seen, 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, and 0.5. These are the relevant facts. And the habit of the student should be to make the points of the relevant aspect or facts of the cases always. But it is not just like a story as the habit of the LLB student, but try to make the points. These are the 4 and 5 points related to the relevant facts. And one of the relevant facts is that after leaving the job, the services of the Bient Coalman company, the respondent has submitted one application by claiming that the compensation may be granted in lieu of the leave which was due when he was working in the Bient Coalman company. Okay. Then after these relevant facts, another aspect which says that the issues in a case, always, unless there will not be the framing of the issue, one cannot make any argument, number one. Number two, the law cannot be taken into account, means that law cannot be taken as a support by any party if there will not be issue. And thirdly, the judgment cannot be delivered by the court. It is very difficult to deliver the judgment. Therefore, the relevant facts are also very essential. And second part is, issues in the case always are very essential. In every stage, it may be in trial stage, it may be in the original jurisdiction stage, or it may be in the appeal, or it may be in the special leave petition or writ petition even. The issues are very relevant. But every issue can be framed on the basis of the relevance of the facts. Relevance fact. If there are the relevant facts, then issue can be made on that ground, on that basis. And these are the portion what were the issue. As I have cited, what law was taken into account to decide this matter? You have seen Section 20 ID Act. You have seen the Section 2, various clauses of the Section 2 of 1955, working conditions of all the employees of the newspaper sector. And you have already seen the Section 5 of that particular act. That particular act means 1955. And you have already seen that the Section 17 of this law. At the same time, the most important aspect which I have cited, that 115 of the Law of Evidence Act, which is related to the estoppel. Now, how the issues can be framed? That number one issue was that, first issue was that whether the to submit or to give the notice was essential before leaving the job. This is the first one. Number two, whether the respondent was bound to follow, or whether the respondent had forgiven his claim because of the doctrine of estoppel. In the another words, you can say that whether the doctrine of estoppel applied on the respondent. This is the second issue. The third issue is that whether after leaving the job, the person can claim any compensation in lieu of the leave. This is the third one. The fourth is, there was the one issue relating to this wages. Whether the wages includes the car allowance and a free telephone and other things. These were the issues. Number one, number two, number three, and number four. Four issues were there. First was application of definition. Second was application of section 5 and 17. The third was 115 of the Evidence Act. And fourth was the notice related issue. And fifth was the related to the wages, and including whether it includes the car allowance or telephone allowance or the other allowances as prescribed under the, you have seen the definition clause. That definition clause is related to the section 2EEE, wages definition is given under the Act 1955. These were the five issues in this case. Now come to into the point that how this case has been decided by the courts by applying the law. The relevant facts are before you, issues are before you, and the law which has applied by the court in this case was that I have narrated, I have expressed the provisions which has applied in this case. The argument before the court by both the party, and before the argument we will go into the judgment of the labor court, because the labor laws applied in this case, and if any matter shall be in dispute, that will go to the labor court, because of the application of Industrial Dispute Act 1947 as written in the various places of the act from beginning to last. That is the section 21, section 2 to 21, the various, and you have seen the section 2 clause G. It has written that if any word is not defined under section 2, that word shall be taken into consideration as the definition is given under the ID Act 1947. Therefore, it is a matter of labor court. And what was the issue before the labor court, and why, what was the basic award, or in the term you can say that the decision of the labor court? The issue were the same, facts were the same, but both the parties had submitted their argument, and they have said, the company, Bient Coleman Company, has said, number one issue is relating to the notice. The Bient Coleman Company said that the respondent, means at that time he was the plaintiff in this case before the labor court, and the company has argued before the labor court that the employee who is claiming the compensation and other portion, that is the section 5, because it is related to the gratuity, and section 17, as I have cited, it is related, heading of the 17 is the that recovery of the dues, which are dues of the employee against the employer. So therefore, the notice was an issue, and in the contradiction of the notice, the company said that he has not submitted notice, 1 month notice or 3 month notice, as the case may be. Therefore, he is not entitled to get any claim. And whereas the claims has been paid to the employee 2000, you have seen that that was 2810 that has been given, and he has given the receipt, and it means he has accepted all the claims. Received was there. The first argument on behalf of the company before the labor court was that he has not submitted notice as per the provisions of law, and second, that he has given the receipt by receiving that 2810 rupees. Therefore, he cannot claim anything, and the 115 is applied on the employee, because now he is stopped. Once he has received, he is stopped. That was the another. Third argument was there that the car allowance and the free telephone does not come within the purview of the definition of the wages as written under section 2EE of the 1955 Act, which says that the wages includes, what is the definition of 2EE? Wages includes the, as you have seen, TA, DA, HA, basic pay, light, water, medical, other, and food grants, etc. Other word is there. There is the other word. It is written other word, because it is not going to be completed. Whether I can take your class, because only 5 minutes it has been given the warning. It has been given the warning whether just after this over of this lecture I will come and I will complete this case. Now these were the arguments where the by the company before the labor court that estoppel is against him, and he has not submitted that notice, and he has given the receipt. And fourth argument was there that according to the definition as prescribed under 1955 Act of the wages, the car allowance and the that free telephone calls cannot within the purview of the definition, because if you will see the section 5 of this Act, for granting the gratuity in case of resignation, in case of death, and in case of the retirement, the employee is entitled to get the gratuity. There is the provision under section 5 of this 1955, and what will include for the purpose of the gratuity, there is the norm, and on the basis of the dues which he has received during the service period, the calculation of the gratuity depends on that amount. That is the section 5. But detail is there, and just I am citing all these things, but you will read all the details and words and provisions of the particular section, because the very limited time we have to deliver this lecture, online lecture, I cannot discuss much with the help of the student. Otherwise, to put the question and ask the question from the student, that is very easy always. But it is very difficult to see the face and psychological attitude and other norms. But anyway, now come to the point, that was the argument of the company before the labor court. And what was the argument of the plaintiff at that time, at the stage of the labor court, before the labor court? And now he is respondent in the Supreme Court, because he has that company has challenged the award given by the labor court on the ground of that mistake of law under Article 136. The argument of the respondent was there. The most important aspect was there. I was a correspondent, and I comes within the definition of the working journalist, as prescribed, as you have seen, the section 2F of that Act 1955. That is okay. There was no dispute on it. Number two, argument of the that plaintiff before the labor court was that the 115 of the Evidence Act does not apply on me. That was the argument. Because of the reason, when I have submitted the resignation, my object was to join to another company. That was the Indian Express. And I was afraid that if I will not receive the amount which they are paying at that time, they were paying to him, that they will not accept the resignation. If the resignation shall not be accepted, then there will be the violation of law. The person cannot join in another job. That was the argument. And therefore, in compulsion, by way of this pressure, I have received that amount and put my signature on the receipt. And that thus is what in compulsion, psychological factor was there, that they will not accept it. That was the second argument. Third argument, that I want to claim from the Bienth Coal Mine Company, and my leave was due when I was in service. I am not claiming anything more which has not been due. Which has been due, only that parts I am claiming. This was the third argument. The fourth argument was there, that the company was given me the car facility and the free calls of the telephone. Therefore, in the definition of the section 2EEE, it is written, at that time it was single E, but later on it has incorporated other words. But his argument was that my car facility and telephone facility comes within the wages for the calculation of the gratuity under section 5 of the Act, because there is one word others, and though the categorically the car facility and the free telephone is not incorporated in the definition, but there is one word that is called the other facility. Under the other facility, my case comes within the definition of the wages. That was the argument of the plaintiff before the labor court. And these arguments were there, and both the parties had cited some judgments in their own favor. And these judgments were in favor of plaintiff, who is at present the respondent, and the company also. As I have said, Abhishek Raja and others cases were, two cases were in favor of the company and two cases were in favor of the plaintiff before the court. But before the labor court. And labor court, what the labor court has done? Labor court has decided the matter in favor of the plaintiff, who was the plaintiff, now who is the respondent in the Supreme Court, and it was decided that he is entitled to get the leave compensation, number one, and he is entitled to get the gratuity according to the provision section 5 of the 1955 Act. And thirdly, court said that it can be recovered as a land revenue as written under section 17 of the 1955 Act. That was the award, that was the decision, because it is a tribunal, it can be used the word, the award, as well as in the judgment the Supreme Court has written the decision of the labor court. Therefore, the word can be used the decision also. Then now, what were the arguments before the Supreme Court? Because the company has lost the case, and the plaintiff, who is respondent in the Supreme Court, has won the case. Then who will go in appeal against this decision of the labor court. Normally, that party will go who had lost the defeated from the labor court. That company has approached and filed the appeal before the Supreme Court. Now you can you can say that, sir, directly how it has gone to the Supreme Court. Under Article 136, because in the industrial dispute, there are the hierarchy, then appeal can be filed to the government and the government can refer the matter to the back to the labor court. And ultimately, there is the provision that only special appeal can be filed to the Supreme Court. Thus, under Article 136, company has filed the special leave petition before the Supreme Court. That is the matter up to the filing of the special leave petition before the Supreme Court. That is the point. Now come under the arguments, judgments, and the reasons which the court have, Supreme Court have decided this matter. It is less than 1 minute. And after that, immediately I will come, because it requires to be completed very soon today. And otherwise, the time is very limited. And this Bhyant Goldman Company case. Now, before the Supreme Court, what was the argument of the both the parties before the Supreme Court, which has filed under this article 1?